from Victoria's racing heartland, the show dedicated to keeping Victoria country racing strong. Welcome to Coffee Country with Harry Coffey, Maggie Payne and Gareth Hall. Where we belong,
country racing strong. Let's welcome in the team for Coffee Country as we talk racing in Country Victoria. Hello to you, first of all, Maggie Payne. I think everybody's excited there if they're based in Warrnambool because for 300 lucky people, they can turn up and watch the races this afternoon.
Yeah, I'm very jealous. Harry will have some friends there and he won't know what's going on with everyone yelling over the fence, hopefully. But yeah, very jealous of everyone heading off to Warrnambool and up to 300. I think they've nearly reached their cap. So okay. Great to see everyone get behind it.
It'd be a little bit weird performing in front of some people there today, Harry. Hello to you.
Yeah, g'day, guys. Yeah, good to have people back. Be interesting to see how it goes, but I'm sure the Warrnambool Club will be prepared and it'll run smoothly. So I might get nervous when I see some people hanging over the fence.
We'll start off with our Hall of Fames. I'll just go with you, Harry. You're my inductee to the Hall of Fame. You've got a Caulfield Cup, right? 52 on your back. Can you win?
I think the wet track, the rain predicted is a key. Like, obviously last start he didn't run very well, but he pulled up a bit lame, was in the vet report. So I think if we go back to his start before when he was flashing home late, in behind non-conformist, Grand Promenade, the Delphi, them sorts of horses, he was only a couple lengths off them, plus a wet track. You know, he's a chance of bobbing into a place. So hopefully that can happen and I can get a real thrill Saturday.
Port Guillaume, of course, is the horse that you are riding for Lindsay Park, Bennett and JD Hayes. They're just training winners for fun. They're training winners at Donald. They're training winners at Ballarat on a Saturday. They had success at the Metro meetings over the last month as well. So how do you go about getting that ride, Harry? When did that all unfold for a Caulfield Cup? Can you take us inside the inner sanctum?
Yeah, they're low-flying, the boys. But I was sort of in the ring early. I think they were sort of gathering together their options on who they might put on the horse. And I think Daniel Stackhouse, who rode the horse last time, he might have went and got a ride that he considered better in Chapada, who he's ridden and ran third in a Group 1 the start before. And as the riders were going, it's sort of hard to find a lighter weight rider, but late last week, my name sort of got thrown up. And then for a brief stage, I was also putting my hat in the ring to ride Persan once Luke Curry was suspended. So I was sort of in the ring for two rides. And then the Mar stable chose Linda. And luckily enough, the Hayes stable still wanted me to ride their horse. So a fair bit goes on, and that's just two horses in that race, what was going on in the final sort of few days before acceptances. So you can imagine what goes on with the whole field, and it's just going to continue happening over the next few weeks with these big races. The rider merry-go-round will continue.
And Gareth mentioned, Harry, 52 kilos. So what's in it for you over the next few days to get down to that?
What I do, I just try to eat and drink as normally as possible, but sort of, you know, put things into my body that aren't going to sit in there, not big, fatty, solid foods. Just stuff that will be easy to lose, because naturally I ride sort of 54 kilos, so I only do have to lose 2 kilos of weight. So if I can sort of get around to the 53 kilo mark easily by Saturday, and then I've got all day to lose sort of that extra little bit. So we're on track at the moment. 6 rides at Warrnambool today will definitely help the task, but it's a long trip home from Warrnambool to Swan Hill, especially if you don't get a winner and you're always a victim of eating junk food. But
yes,
I've got mum driving me, so hopefully we can keep on the straight and narrow, get home safely and not eat too much crap.
Your mum's a superstar. Say hello to Mrs. Coffey for us, young fella, because your mum is a superstar and she's done well to drive you there today, Harry. So Delphi's at 52.5, D. Oliver will be riding Delphi at. What would he be like in the jockey's room if he headed to Warrnambool today? Do some jockeys get a little bit angry if they're wasting too hard, Harry? Can you take us inside some of those conversations with a few of the jocks?
Yeah, no doubt. It can change your personality. Even myself, like, I don't even really have to wait. And just the fact that you know that with the last 24 to 48 hours before the ride, it's going to be a real mental struggle. as soon as you find out you're riding that weight, I feel like your character, you know, changes and your mood can swing. And the poor, like my partner, like I try to keep a pretty relaxed, pretty relaxed sort of frame of mind, but even she would probably feel the change in mood, especially come dinner time and that. Like you might sit down and have a big feed and then after it you feel a bit guilty and, you know, they're who you're living with and they cop it. But in the jockey's room, there's no doubt there's some boys that are used to it. Like Jamie Mott, incredible rider who would lose massive amounts of weight each and every day, and he's one of the nicest guys that you'll ever come across. So he's just someone that's become used to it. But then, yeah, some of the other boys, they're a bit angry. And one bloke in particular who never would have had to lose a dime of weight in his life is Dean Yendall. He's the most angry man in the room. And I'd hate to know what he'd have to do if he had to miss some chicken nuggets with Mia and Christine on the way home from the races. But, it is mentally probably pretty draining, and your people that you surround yourself with do have to go through the emotions with you of getting down to a light weight, but that's why you surround yourself with good people.
Dean Yendall doesn't bring in a pie and sauce, does he, sometimes midway through a meeting? Just to rub it in.
During COVID, it's been tricky. Like, a few of the boys would usually duck out and get a steak sanger, like Dean Holland and Dean Yendall and them types. But during COVID, it's been a little bit tricky lately because you sort of can't just go out and do what you like. We're all locked up for protocol reasons. But a while ago, Freddie Kersley rode a nice winner in Melbourne and at Wangaratta on the Monday. He brought two bucket loads of KFC into the rooms and shouted everyone. So that was a very rare thing to see in a jockey's room, is a bit of old chook flying around.
Yeah, he's a good man, young Fred Kersley Jr. Your Hall of Fame nomination this week, Maggie?
Well, there's been lots of highlights across the week, including the two country cups, but I'm going to go to Kyneton Races on Tuesday with Ben Spall, who's familiar to our program from racing.com now. He went out there to do the interviews on course, and Rick Mack got the late scratching. He was feeling a bit ill, and he got the late call up to call the races. So I think that was a pretty good effort from Ben to switch tack a bit and head up into the commentary box.
Well done, Benny. Well done. That is a terrific effort. What about you, Harry?
I'm going with Jai on I'm Thunderstruck. That was brilliant to watch.
Yeah.
It was a really nice ride. And there was a lot of, I'll go with the word crap, in the media about his ride on the horse the start before. And in my opinion, there wasn't much else he could do. He was on a green raw horse that drew a wide gate. He got back and got bumped around the corner and it flew home. And yeah, it was unlucky, but it wasn't his fault. And he came out with all that scrutiny against him and absolutely delivered a peach. So, well done, Joy.
Do you take offence to that when some of the people in the media, definitely not us here on Coffee Country, get stuck into some jockeys about a ride? Do you get frustrated sometimes, Harry, that they just don't quite understand what you guys have to do as a jockey and when you've got a split second to make a decision?
I get frustrated when people don't understand, what a horse's pattern can be changed by a bad barrier. Mm-hmm. And I also get frustrated when, people in the media or an owner or even, people that do form battle to read a race and understand why a rider might make a certain decision. And everyone does make mistakes, but sometimes they're actually not mistakes. They're decisions that are made at split seconds that happen because of reasons out of our control. And sometimes we get blamed that it is in our control, when really it's not. And I felt like Jai's ride on Thunderstruck in the Rupert Clark, there wasn't anything he could do other than maybe sit right out the back and go 88 wide around him. And I don't think the horse would have won anyway, and he would have been in trouble for going too wide and thinking he was on winks. So he had to put all that aside. There was a few things on the Twitter saying that it should have won and it cost it. But you've got to remember, it drew 15. It was a green horse, first time at Group 1 level. But yeah, he came out the other day, drew a better gate, was able to sit handier, took neat runs, didn't get bumped over, and what was the result? He won. So it does get frustrating, but that's a part of the game. That's our profession. You've got to get used to it, and you've got to move on to the next ride.
What does your mum Marie say when she watches a helicopter view of you jockeys taking those rides like Jai did there the other day at Caulfield? And what happens there when Jai comes back into the room and goes, geez, that was good fun, but geez, it got tight? What do you talk about in that situation, Harry?
Mum really, she doesn't really say too much.
No.
I'd say her and Dad would definitely sit back on the couch from time to time and push into the pillow and put their heels down, especially Dad. But I think when they watch races together, they're both trying not to go the early crow when I hit the front, because whoever does gets a spray from the other person. But I'm sure Michelle McNeil would have had her heart in her mouth when Jai was taking some neat runs. But in saying that, those sort of runs that Jai took, they do happen quite regularly. It was just the fact that the helicopter shot is at Caulfield on a big day that it was seen. So, you know, if you have that helicopter shot at Kyneton on a Monday, going into the first corner from a bad 1,400 metre start, that happens there as well. You just don't have the footage or the media coverage what was at Caulfield Saturday. But the fact that he was able to pull that off in circumstances at the highest level under enormous pressure is what he was in my Hall of Fame for.
Yep, brilliant ride from the Kerrang boy. Now, our special guest now for our country character. And this man, I would imagine, would be a little bit excited, like some of his fellow patrons heading on to the Warrnambool Book course there this afternoon for that race meeting, because crowds for the first time for a long time are allowed to head back. Limited crowds, but still, it's a start anyway. And Shane Kerr, of course, is a Warrnambool Race Club member, and he joins us now. G'day, Shane. Are you excited, mate?
Yeah, look, be part of the 300. It's great to get back on course, and looking forward to a good day.
How do you get to be a part of that 300 group of people that can turn up to the races this afternoon?
Oh, there's two avenues, but this one was by application and ballot, either as a member and an owner or an owner.
So, and Shane, I'm sure you were ready for the day. You've been to the races a few times, but what's your plan? Are you on to the races now and heading excited with a few other people, or what's your plan for the day?
Myself and a mate going to head there. I'm just looking at the form guide now and seeing where I'll put my money on.
Well, Harry, have you got a winner for Shane? He's heading to the races. You've got a few rides there. What would be your best there this afternoon?
I reckon Shane should have $5 on Fabian Spirit. And if he likes to have more than $5 on something, have more than that.
All right, then. Fabian Spirit, what race is that in? That's race six,
number six, right onto it.
he's ready to go, Shane. Hey, how much have you missed the races, and how important is a race club like Warrnambool to the local community for the people that just enjoy heading to the races when they can?
Oh, look, I've been a local here now just over 20 years, and look, started going to the races, got a few small shares in a couple of syndicates. Now, that's a great interest. But socially, it's just fantastic. You get out there with everyone and alike, and the crowds down here are fantastic. Jericho Cup and the May races, the carnival's fantastic. For the town itself, it's worth a lot of money.
Yeah, that's right. And it is such a big racing community, and not only Warrnambool, but that whole southwest. Now, Shane, you were a copper in the local region, so you would have seen overseen a few May carnivals. What about the sales down there at Warrnambool? Did they ever get full on the first week of May?
Look, the first week of May traditionally has been really good. You know, all your punters and your experienced gamblers that come down here and follow the races, they're really good. We had one mishap a couple of years ago on a Tuesday. It was the only incident we had for the whole races where one of our local hotels, one of the punters got on a table and fell off and broke his leg. That's the only thing that we've really had a problem with. We've thrown a lot of resources at it over the years, and look, underage drinking was an issue, but we've got that in check.
So how do you approach the race meeting then today, Shane? Do you like a quaddy? Is it a running double? Or you just go straight to the beer and have a nice cold beer?
Yeah, look, there's three of us in a quaddy today, so yeah, we'll have a look at that. And I've got a small interest in one of Simon Wild's horses running in race two.
Okay.
So I'll be following that one closely too.
All right then, so race two, is he tipping at Simon? He's in great form. Is that Power of Song? It's the favourite at 260 with D. Endel aboard.
Yeah, that is Power of Song. So yeah, we'll be looking at that. And on top of Cirillo yesterday at Caulfield, you know, we're having a great time.
Oh, geez. Pockets are full, and you're in a group one now with Cirillo Miss. I think she's heading towards the Empire Rose. That's exciting.
Yeah, I'm not sure what Simon's going to do with it. We'll see what happens as she pulls up. She looked all right this morning down the beach, just having a little swim in the water there, but yeah, looked real good.
Good on you, Shane. Thanks for that. And good luck at the races. Enjoy. I'm jealous.
Hopefully, we'll be back on track soon.
All right, then. There's Shane Keogh there. Hey, Harry, I do have to bring something up with you, by the way. I was texting Maggie there the other day, and you were just dominating proceedings at Benalla, which I think you just... Benalla's your track. You ride at a treat. And I said, didn't Harry Tippis win in the last race that he's best at $8? And he's just... his previous horse that he rode won about at $8 and won by about six lengths. Won like far that. And then what happened, Harry? You finished dead last on the one that you thought would win.
That's exactly right. Don't jockeys have absolutely no idea? I looked at my ride and I thought, oh, could be a bit of a tough day. Who's your pappy goes all right. So it's a safe and sound bet. And I thought, I'll ride it good. Anyway, it ran last and I sat three wide on it. So yeah. I got that completely wrong. At least I put my hand up and say that I got it wrong. Come on, Harry.
Yes, and that's why you're such a... That's why we all love you, Harry. But you rode a treat for the most of the day anyway, Harry. I thought you were... If I had to give the 3-2 one out, you definitely would have got the three votes. What about Avoca Cup this weekend, Maggie? It's a terrific day on the calendar, but unfortunately we can't get there. And Bendigo have their Saturday meeting as well on Saturday.
Yeah, and we've also got the Moe Cup tomorrow, which has come up pretty strong, so that's a Friday race meeting, but Avoca Cup on Saturday and Bendigo, which is normally their big beach party race day, but unfortunately can't get people there. And then we wrap up the weekend with Horsham Cup. So we've got three country cups in the matter of 3 days. So looking forward to some great racing.
So what's your schedule this weekend, Harry? So you're at Caulfield on Saturday. What about Sunday?
Yeah, got Horsham on Sunday, riding Global Gift in the cup at Horsham. But he's also accepted in the Avoca Cup as first emergency, drawn well, and he's also in at Moe tomorrow. So in all the three country cup venues for the weekend, Global Gift is down to run, so he's going to be the star of the show somewhere. But, I've got a nice day at Horsham on Sunday, ride to Tunka in the Melbourne Cup Challenge heat, and I've got a few for Dad as well, so get through the Caulfield Cup and then back to reality at Horsham on Sunday.
So after Caulfield, do you go back to Swan Hill and then to Horsham, or you go stay in Melbourne then head to Horsham on the Sunday?
Haven't actually got through that. I didn't plan that. I'll have to work that out, Gareth. But if I need a bed, I might be ringing you, mate.
All right then, mate. No problems. Dana's headed back to Perth for a little while, so there's a couple of rooms there for you, Harry, so I'll look after you. Say hello to your mum for us and tell her thank you very much for driving you to Warrnambool so you could join us for Coffee Country.
The radio is saying hello, mum. yeah, knows that you're with us today. She's doing a good job. She's just winding through, just about to get to Warrnambool now. So yep. It's a big trip from Swan Hill. You need a bit of company.
What a superstar Mellie Gill she is. Good on you, Harry.
Thanks, Gareth.
Good on you, Maggie.
Thanks, Gareth.
And that is Coffee Country on this Thursday. Let's head to